Hello students, today in this lecture we will discuss about different types of grinding wheel materials available, then how they are graded, what is the grain size and what is the structure that is required to interpret them. In our previous lecture we have discussed about the specification of grinding wheel, and in that we have studied that what is the grain, what is grade and what is structure. So similarly, that part in detail now we will discuss with one by one, keeping each and every parameter in mind. So the first one, that is the grinding wheel materials. And as we know, these grinding wheel materials are nothing but the abrasives used. And these abrasives used, that are might be a natural abrasives or that might be a artificial abrasives. So based on requirement, natural abrasives may be used or artificial abrasives that may be also used. So let us have a look over here. So the natural abrasives that are available, they are the sandstone, emery, quartz, corundum and the diamond. So these names you need to remember, because by keeping these names in clarity, you will come to know that these are the natural abrasives that are directly available from the mines. And similarly, other artificial abrasives are also available, which can be used in practical purpose also. They are the aluminium oxide, silicon carbide and the artificial diamonds, the diamonds that are made artificially. So these are the different types of material that are used as abrasive wheel material. Now, what is the difference or what is the variation in using natural abrasive and artificial abrasive, that we will study. So starting with first natural abrasives, these natural abrasives are directly available from the mines, and there is a variation in the abrasives that are obtained from the mines. If we talk about the emery, then this emery material contains 60 to 70% of aluminium oxide, that is Al2O3, and the remaining is iron oxide and the impurities. Similarly, if we discuss about another natural material, that is the corundum, then this corundum has 70 to 90% aluminium oxide and the other are impurities. So now you will understand that what is the difference between this emery and the corundum. Because these are the naturally available materials, and naturally if that material have 60 to 70% of aluminium oxide only, then it is given name as the emery, and if it is above 70 to 90%, then it is called as the corundum material. Similarly, as we have discussed or as we have listed the natural abrasive, the another abrasive that is used, that is the quartz, and it is mainly a grindstone shape. So next one, that is the diamond, and this diamond is available in natural form and it is used for dressing grinding wheel, and it is also used to grind hard materials also. Next, these are the list of natural abrasives available that we have listed in our previous slide. Again, the list is, first one is emery, second one is corundum, next one is quartz, next is diamond, and the another one, that is the combination of all these different types of abrasives. Now the another type, that is the artificial abrasives, and some of the most widely used artificial abrasives, which are the first one, that is the brown aluminium oxide, and this aluminium oxide is used for general purpose for grinding tough materials. The next, that is the white aluminium oxide, and this white aluminium oxide is used for grinding ferrous and ferrous alloys. Similarly, if this green silicon carbide, if we discuss about this, then this green silicon carbide is used for very hard materials, and these hard materials have very low tensile strength, and we can take example of the cemented carbide. So based on the requirement, if it is a general purpose, then we will use brown aluminium oxide. Similarly, if it is the requirement of grinding ferrous materials or ferrous alloys, at that time the white aluminium oxide is used, and If the material is very hard and it has very low tensile strength, such as the cemented carbide, at that time this green silicon carbide is also used. So these are the different types of abrasives available in the market, which are used based on the requirement. So now let us start with our next topic, that is the grain or grit. Please keep this word in mind. Many times this grain is also known as the grit. It is most widely used word, that is the grain, but sometimes it is called as the grit. So first of all, the grain or grit number, that indicates in a general way the size of the abrasive grains used in a making wheel, that we have discussed in our previous slide also, because in previous lecture we have studied the detailed specification that is used for the grinding wheel. Similarly, as we have discussed in our previous lecture, this grain indicates the number of particles that can be accommodated in the per square inch area that is available on the screen. The next, as we have listed in our last lecture also, if the size of the grain is from 10 to 24, and then that particles are called as the coarse particles or coarse grain, and its specific application, that is the rapid material removal. As the size of particle is very large, it is helpful to remove more material from the workpiece. Similarly, if the size is in the range of 30 to 60, then that are called as the medium grain particles or medium grains, and it is used for stock removal and finishing both. Next, if the size is 80, 100, 120, 150 or 180, then it is called as the fine grain, and it is used for less stock removal and high surface finish. That means use of these particular particles are for finishing purpose only, and the material removal takes place is very less. And other than this, if more than 220 we consider up to 600, then that grains are called as the very fine grains, and these are specifically used for high surface finish. And these are also used many times for grinding the hard materials. So these are the different applications of the different types of grains available in the market. So the next part, that is the grade. And as we have discussed in our previous session, I am noting that these all topics are covered, or the basic of all this topic is covered in our previous lecture. So first, watch this video very clearly. After that, you will get the knowledge of this part very clearly. So what is the grade? This grade, the term, it is as applied as to grinding wheel, and this refers to the tenacity or hardness with which the bond holds the cutting points or abrasive grains in the place. So in another word, specifically if we say, this grade indicates the hardness level that is available in that wheel. Next, these grades are indicated as the soft grade, it may be a medium grade, or it may be a hard grade. And it is nothing but the resistance to a bond offers to a disruption of the abrasives. If we similarly say, what is the meaning of this soft material and what is the meaning of this hard grade? So if we see a wheel from which the abrasive grains can easily be dislodged, then it is called as the soft grade. That means from the abrasive wheel, if the abrasives are removed from that wheel very easily, then they are called as the soft grade. And if the grains that are added to that wheel are fixed very tightly, or if they are attached to the wheel very securely, then they are called as the hard grade. So based on the attachment of that abrasive particles with the grinding wheel, we can say that if this is the soft grade wheel or this is the hard grade. And based on this requirement, maybe hard grade or maybe a soft grade depends on the material that we want to finish. And simply we have summarized over here, and there is many times variation in the grade indicated in the range of soft, medium and hard, but in normal cases, A to H indicates the soft grade, I to P indicates the medium grade, and Q to Z indicates the hard grade. Now next, our main part, that is the structure. And what is the interpretation of this structure? So this term indicates the spacing between, clearly use this word, it indicates the spacing between abrasive grains. And as we see, or as we have learned in many of the subject, that if the particles are closely packed, then we can say it has higher density. If they are spaced at a certain distance, then we can say that it has the lower density. So we can, and in another word, we can also define that it indicates the density of the wheel. So this structure may indicate a spacing between abrasive grains, or it may indicate the density of the wheel. So if the higher proportion of bond is considered as an open structure, whereas the lower proportion considered as a closed structure. So it depends on the proportion of the bond. So if we consider a specific application for grinding brittle and hard material, dense structure is considered. Please keep this in mind. For grinding brittle and hard material, dense structure is required, because during friction there are larger forces are required for material removal, whereas for soft and tough material, open structure can be used. So if the space between the particles is comparatively large, if the space between the particle is small, based on this open and closed structure is defined. Over here we have shown the application of these different types of structure used. First, if we say if it is the dense structure, then in specification of grinding wheel, it might have given a designation, such as it may be a 1, 2, 3 or 4. And this dense word indicates that it is applicable for cutting and snagging, and also for finishing of the hard and brittle materials. If the structure is medium and its range is up to 5 to 8, then these are mostly used for 90% of the grinding wheel. That means this medium type of structure is available in 90% of the grinding wheel. In general cases, this medium type of the structure is available. Now if the open structure is available, it has the range from 9 to 14 as given over here, and it is used for soft, tough and ductile materials such as brass and bronze. So these are the different application of the grinding wheel based on the structure available in it. And by combining all different parameters, one can decide that which type of grinding wheel is required for machining, maybe a cast iron, maybe a stainless steel, maybe a bronze, it may be a steel material. So based on requirement, one can choose different type of structure, different types of grain, different types of abrasive material, or maybe a different size of grit particles also. So other parameters that we have discussed in our specification of grinding wheels, that we will discuss in detail in our further lecture. So looking forward to see you all in our next lecture. Up to then, thank you.